गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन स्टूडेंट्स. नाउ द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन ना डी एंड एफ लाइक एलिमेंट्स विल सी दैट हाउ डू यू अकाउंट फॉर द इरेगुलर वेरिएशन ऑफ आयोनाइजेशन एंथैल्पी दैट इज फर्स्ट एंड सेकंड इन द फर्स्ट सीरीज ऑफ ट्रांजिशन एलिमेंट्स. फर्स्ट सीरीज ऑफ ट्रांजिशन एलिमेंट्स मीन्स 3D सीरीज एलिमेंट्स फ्रॉम स्कैंडियम टू जिंक, राइट. सो विद रेस्पेक्ट टू फर्स्ट आयोनाइजेशन एंथैल्पी एंड सेकंड आयोनाइजेशन एंथैल्पी इरेगुलर वेरिएशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस नाउ. Right? So first we will see irregularities in the first ionization enthalpy. Ionization enthalpy symbol is delta H I. I means ionization. Enthalpy symbol is what change in enthalpy delta H. First ionization enthalpy is represented by delta H I 1. Right? Second ionization enthalpy is represented by delta H I 2. In place of 1 we will take 2. Right? So what are the irregularities in first ionization enthalpy we will discuss. You take the trend is irregular because of removal of the electron alters the relative energies of 4s and the 3d orbitals. That means 3d series elements if you take scandium, argon, 4s, scandium 21, right? Argon 4s to 3d1. Okay, na? Next titanium, argon 4s to 3d2. Like that, if you observe the incoming electron enter into n-1 d orbital. Then suppose if you remove any electron from the D subshell or from S subshell, reorganization of energy is taking place between what? 4s and 3d orbitals, which leads to reorganization energy accompanying ionization. The trend is irregular because of the removal of the electron alters the relative energies of 4s and 3d orbitals, which leads to reorganization energy accompanying ionization. How it is, you will see that this results into release of exchange energy. Exchange energy, what is the meaning of exchange energy, students? The energy released when two or more electrons of the same spin exchange, their positions in the degenerate orbitals of the same subshell. In the degenerate orbitals of the same subshell. Already we have discussed about this exchange energy in the first PUC, right? In atomic structure, last concept. Exchange energy is nothing but the energy released when two or more electrons with the same spin exchange their positions in the degenerate orbitals of the same subshell. For example, if you take D subshell, I have taken here. D subshell possesses 5 orbitals. Suppose each orbital possesses 1 electron. Here, how do we get exchange? The energy released when two or more electrons exchange their positions in the degenerate orbitals of the same subshell. This is a D subshell. Degenerate orbitals. What are degenerate orbitals? The orbitals which are having the same energy, right? Such type of orbitals generally we call as what? Degenerate orbitals. These are the degenerate orbitals. That means what? Here this electron spin may exchange by the second electron or third electron or fourth electron and the fifth electron. How many exchanges we have got? With the second electron, how many exchanges we will get? With third electron, how many exchanges we will get? Like that we have to calculate. Then only we will get exchange energy. Exchange energy is nothing but the energy released when two or more electrons of the same spin exchange their positions in the degenerate orbitals of the same subshell is called what? Exchange energy. Here exchange energy term is important. This results into that reorganization of energy, results into release of exchange energy, which increases with increase in number of electrons in d power n. See that here d power 5, d power n value increases, number of exchanges will increase. D power n value increases, number of exchanges will increase, exchange energy also will increase, students. So, right, which increases with increase in number of electrons in D power n configuration and also from transference of S electrons into D orbitals. So, there is a chance to exchange the electrons from S orbital to D orbital also in this, right. So, this type of irregularities we can identify in the first ionization enthalpy. For example, you can take chromium. Chromium has lower ionization enthalpy. Delta HI is nothing but what? Ionization enthalpy. Chromium has lower ionization enthalpy. enthalpy due to the removal of one electron leads to stable d5 configuration. That means what students, here chromium if you take, what is the electronic configuration of chromium? Chromium is 24. So argon 4s1 3d5. Now suppose if you want to remove an electron, ionization enthalpy is nothing but what? The amount of energy is required to remove an electron from an isolated neutral gaseous atom, right? Suppose if you want to remove an electron from chromium atom, we need to require some amount of energy, right? So see that here chromium electronic configuration is argon 4s1 3d5. We can easily remove the electron from 4s subshell. So that's why chromium has a lower first ionization enthalpy. Due to the removal of one electron leads to stable d5 configuration we are getting, students. But whereas if you take a zinc, zinc has the highest ionization energy. Why? Because zinc, if you take, zinc is atomic number 30. What is the electronic configuration? Argon 4s2 3d5. Sorry, 3d10. D subshell is completely filled with 10 electrons. S subshell is completely filled with 2 electrons. So both are stable here. Both are stable. So that's why here we cannot remove the electron that much easily. Zinc has the highest ionization energy because it has both the orbitals completely filled, that is 3d10 and 4s2 students. So that's why this is what very stable configuration. From very stable configuration we cannot remove the electron that much easily. So because of that reason here zinc has the highest ionization energy, chromium has lower ionization energy, right? Like this we can identify some irregularities in first ionization enthalpy, right? In the similar manner, how do we identify irregularities in the second ionization enthalpy also? We'll see that, students. You copy this one. Let us see irregularities in the second ionization enthalpy, that is delta HI2, second ionization enthalpy. After removal of second ionization enthalpy means the amount of energy is required to remove an electron from unipositively charged ion, right? Means second electron we are going to remove, right? So after removal of first electron, what will happen? The electronic configurations like D5 and D10 are exceptionally stable. Suppose if you take chromium only, chromium electronic configuration is argon 4s1 3d5. After removal of one electron, it will become what? A Cr+1. What is the configuration of this argon 3d5 4s0? See that it is very highly stable 3d5 configuration. Can we remove one more electron from this configuration that much easily? No. So we have to require more and more amount of energy if you want to remove an electron from such type of stable configuration, right? So in the similar manner, if you take copper electronic configuration is argon 4s1 3d10. Suppose you have removed one electron from this, so it will become argon 3d10 4s0. So 3d10 is very highly stable configuration. So can we remove that? Can we remove the electron from such type of stable configuration? No. So that's why second ionization enthalpy of chromium and copper is very very high. So see that the configuration like D5 and D10 are exceptionally stable. So removal of second electron from chromium and copper is very difficult and show much higher value, students. One example I have given to you, how it will show the irregularities, right? I hope everybody understood this. This question they have asked one time, I think. So it is there is a chance to ask this question for 3 marks also sometimes. Sometimes they are asking for 2 marks, right? Okay, you can copy this. Let us see, students, the next question. Which is a stronger reducing agent, Cr+2 or Fe+2, and why? Cr+2 is a good reducing agent. What is the meaning of reducing agent? The substance which undergoes oxidation. The substance which undergoes oxidation is called reducing agent. Here Cr+2 is a good reducing agent than Fe+2 because according to standard reduction potential values, if you take the substance which is having the lower reduction potential act as reducing agent. The substance which is having the higher reduction potential act as oxidizing agent. So according to reduction potential values, if you observe, this chromium ion has a less standard reduction potential value than Fe+2, right? This chromium plus 3 E0 reduction potential symbol is what? E naught. Standard reduction potential symbol is what? E naught. E naught Cr plus 3 by Cr plus 2 value is negative value. E naught Fe plus 3 by Fe plus 2 value is what? Positive value. So negative value means lower value than positive, right? So the reduction potential which is having the lower value, that will act as reducing agent. Higher value act as what? Oxidizing agent. So among the Cr plus 2 and Fe plus 2, Cr plus 2 is a good reducing agent, students. According to standard reduction potential values we have taken, right? And next question, why Cr plus 2 reducing, Mn plus 3 oxidizing when both have D4 configuration? Suppose if you observe here, chromium electronic configuration. Chromium atomic number is 24, right? Electronic configuration is what? Argon 4s1 3d5. Everybody knows that. So chromium plus 2 they are asking, right? Chromium plus 2 configuration, it loses 2 electrons. That means what? Argon 3d4 we have got 4s0, right? In the similar manner, you can observe manganese. Manganese atomic number is 25. 25 means electronic configuration argon 4s2 3d5. But here manganese plus 3. Plus 3 means argon 2 electrons lost from 4s substrate, 1 electron lost from 3d. So it also the same configuration 3d4 4s0. See that? That's why they have asked. Why Cr plus 2 reducing and Mn plus 3 oxidizing when both have D4 configuration? See that? Here also D4 configuration. Cr plus 2 and Mn plus 3. What is the reason behind it? Means whenever it loses the electron, this D4 configuration will become part of D3 configuration. This is the oxidation process, by oxidation process, right? So D3 configuration we have got. This D3 configuration is highly stable configuration according to crystal field theory. Why? Because T2z means what? 3 orbitals, right? T2z orbitals are what? Dxy, dyz, dzx orbitals. Dz orbitals are what? Dx square, y square, dz square. According to crystal field theory, this D3 configuration is very, very stable because in T2z, how many orbitals are present? 3 orbitals. Each orbital is filled with water, 1 electron. A half filled configuration is highly stable, right? According to crystal field theory, right? So that's why D3 configuration is highly stable here. In the similar manner, if you observe Mn plus 3 gain 1 electron and it will be converting into what? Mn plus 2. That means what? Your gaining of an electron, addition of one more electron in D substrate will take place. So 3d4 will be converting into what? 3d5. It is a half filled configuration. Half filled configurations are highly stable, we know already that. So because of that reason, Mn plus 3 will be converting into Mn plus 2. You may ask a question here, Mn plus 3, if it loses one electron, it will be converting into D3, no sir? Yes. But according to D black elements, if you observe, chromium exhibits the stable electronic configuration, stable oxidation state, that is plus 3 and plus 6. What is the stable oxidation states of chromium means? Plus 3 and plus 6. What is the stable oxidation state of manganese means? That is plus 2 and plus 7, right? So plus 2 plus 7 are the stable oxidation states of manganese and plus 3 and plus 6 are the stable oxidation states of chromium, students. So because of that reason, here chromium loses one electron to get a stable oxidation state of chromium plus 3. Here manganese plus 3 ion gains one more electron to get the stable electron configuration of Mn plus 2, students. Okay, now I hope everybody understood this. So here this undergo reduction. This will undergo what? Oxidation process. Undergo oxidation, right? So the substance which undergo oxidation is called what? Reducing, right? So Cr plus 2 will act as reducing agent, Mn plus 3 will act as what? Oxidizing agent, even though both have the same electronic configuration, that is D4. Okay, na? Okay, copy this one, amma. Let us see, students, the next important question, that is, write the general electronic configuration of F block elements. There is a chance to ask for one more question. So we know that F-lock elements means the elements in which The last electron will enter into the anti-penultimate shell, that is n minus 2 f sub shell, right? So the electronic configuration will be like this: n minus 2 f 1 to 14, n minus 1 d 0 or 1 or 0 to 1 ns 2. This is the electronic configuration of f black elements. Okay. And next question, most important question. In the public examination, there is a chance to ask sometimes 3 marks question they are asking. Sometimes this is 2 marks question also they are asking, right? As a 2 mark also they are asking. What is the lanthanoid contraction? Write any one consequence of lanthanoid contraction. Write any one consequence of lanthanoid contraction they have asked here. You see that. What is the meaning of lanthanoid contraction? The overall decrease of atomic or ionic radii due to poor shielding effect of 4f electrons, we can call as what, the lanthanoid contraction. The overall decrease in atomic radii and ionic radii from lanthanum to lutetium is called what? Lanthanoid contraction. Why the atomic radii is decreasing, sir? How the electron is entering here in lanthanoids? The electron will enter into the 4f subshell. The last electron will enter into the 4f subshell. We know already that shielding effect. What is the shielding effect? Order of various subshells. S subshell is greater than P subshell. P subshell is greater than D subshell. D subshell is greater than F subshell. With respect to what? Shielding effect, right? Shielding effect. That means what? S electrons can easily shield or screen between the valence shell and nucleus, right? Here than P subshell, than D subshell, than F subshell. Here the electron, valency electron enter into the F subshell. So F subshell electrons are cannot shield. So because of that reason, what we can say here, poor shielding effect of 4F subshell electrons, the atomic radii or ionic radii gradually decreases because nuclear charge increases, but the number of electrons added into 4F subshell, it cannot shield or screen between the nucleus and valency electron. So automatically what happens? The electron attraction towards the nucleus will increase. Whenever the electron attraction towards the nucleus increases, atomic radii decreases. So because of that reason, we can say due to this lanthanoid contraction, second and the third transition series elements shows almost same atomic radii. Why zirconium and hafnium possess the same atomic radii, similar atomic radii, they will ask you. What is the reason? Due to poor shielding effect of 4F subshell electrons, or else due to lanthanoid contraction, we can write students. That is the main reason here. So what are the reasons? Means increase in nuclear charge and poor shielding effect of 4F electrons than D electrons. So our main reasons these two. What are the consequences of this lanthanoid contraction, they have asked students. What is the lag consequence means? See that we just now we have seen due to the shielding effect, what happens? The atomic radii of second and third transition series elements are almost identical because of lanthanoid contraction, right? Why second and third transition series elements show same similar atomic radii means due to lanthanoid contraction. Very simple, due to lanthanoid contraction. This sentence alone they are asking as one marker, again as a question, right? And separation of lanthanoids from one another, it is very difficult. So these are the consequences of what are lanthanoid contraction, students. I hope everybody understood this. You copy this one. Let us see, students, the next question, important question. Zirconium and hafnium have almost identical ready. Give reason. This question there is a chance to ask in different manner. That is, second and third transition series of D black shows identical radii, give reason, or else 4D series and 5D series elements shows almost identical radii, give reasons. There is a chance to ask in different manner, but the answer is what? Due to lanthanoid contraction, enough. You have to write only due to lanthanoid contraction or poor shielding effect of 4F electrons than D electrons, these elements shows almost identical radii, students. Okay, na? Very, very important question. Name the member of the lanthanoid series which is well known to exhibit plus 4 oxidation state. What is that member of lanthanoid series? Means helium. cesium plus 4 oxidation state is very stable oxidation state. Why? Because why it is cesium, you will see that. Cesium symbol is what? Ce. Ce electronic configuration is xenon 4f1 5d1 6s2. See that? If it loses one electron from 4f subshell, 5d subshell one electron, from 6s subshell two electrons, total four electrons if it loses, it get the noble gas configuration, which is highly stable, right? Name the member of the lanthanoid series which is well known to exhibit plus 4 oxidation state, means cesium, because it exhibits a xenon electronic configuration after losing 4 electrons, students. So that is the main reason involved in it. Next, cesium exhibits plus 4 oxidation state. Give reason why. Just now we have seen the formation of cesium 4 is powered by its noble gas configuration, which is nothing but what? Xenon. Okay, na? I hope everybody understood this. Take the screenshot. Let us see, students, the next question. Cesium plus 4 is good oxidizing agent. Why? What is the reason behind it? You see that. Cesium plus 4 is a good oxidizing agent. What is the meaning of oxidizing agent? The substance which undergoes reduction. The substance which undergoes reduction is called what? Oxidizing agent. Here, cesium plus 4 will be converting into cesium plus 3. Because cesium plus 4 electronic configuration is a xenon electronic configuration, which is a more stable electronic configuration only. Even though this cesium plus 4 gains one electron and it will be converting into cesium plus 3. Cesium plus 3 is also more stable electronic configuration. Why? Because see that here cesium is belongs to F flag, the common oxidation state, the most stable common oxidation state of F flag elements is plus 3 oxidation state. So that's why every element try to get a plus 3 oxidation state in case of F flag elements, students. So because of that reason here, because cesium plus 4 has a tendency to get more stable oxidation state, that is plus 3. So because of that reason, it will act as what, a good oxidizing agent. Even though it possesses a xenon electronic configuration, the cesium plus 4 will be converting into what? Cesium plus 3, right? So this is also one of the important question we have. And next one is, cesium exhibits a plus 4 oxidation state, europium exhibits a plus 2 oxidation state. Why? In plus 4 oxidation state, cesium has xenon 4F0. In plus 4 oxidation state, cesium has what? Xenon 4F0. Already we have seen this. Because cesium electronic configuration is what? Xenon 4F1, 5D1, 6s2. So after losing the 4 electrons, plus 4 oxidation state means it lose 1 electron from 4f subshell, it lose 1 electron from 5d subshell, it lose 2 electrons from 6s subshell. So it will become what? A xenon 4f0, right? In plus 2 oxidation state, europium has xenon 4f7. 4f7. How it is means, europium electronic configuration is a xenon 4F7, 5D0, 6S2, right? So, in 6S subshell, it loses 2 electrons and it will become what? Xenon 4F7. Here, 4F7 is a half-filled configuration. F subshell contains how many orbitals? Total 7 orbitals. So, each orbital filled with 1 electron according to Hund's rule. So, half-filled configuration is very highly stable, students. We know already that half-filled and completely filled electronic configurations are more stable. So, because of that reason here europium is a more stable electronic configuration in plus 2, right? So, because of that reason here, cesium exhibits plus 4 oxidation state, europium exhibits what? A plus 2 oxidation state. Because this is stable electronic configuration, this is also stable electronic configuration, students. I hope everybody understood. And one more important question for one mark question, that is, what is the composition of mixed metal? What is the composition of mixed metal? Mixed metal is the mixture of 95% of lanthanoid metal, 5% of iron, and the traces of sulfur, carbon, calcium, and aluminium. This is the composition of water, mixed metal, students. There is a chance to ask one mark question. Everybody should copy this. Okay, let us see, students, the next question. Octanoid contraction is greater from element to element than lanthanoid contraction duration. Just now we have discussed about lanthanoid contraction. That is the overall decrease in atomic and ionic radius of lanthanum to lutetium is called what? Lanthanoid contraction. We know already that. Because of lanthanoid contraction, 4D series and 5D series elements shows almost same similar atomic radii, right? But here actinide contraction is greater from element to element than lanthanide contraction. Lanthanide contraction is due to poor shielding effect of 4F electrons, but actinide contraction is poor shielding effect of 5F electrons. See that actinide contraction is greater than lanthanide contraction due to poor shielding effect of 5F electrons in the actinides than that of 4F electrons. Compared to 4F electrons, I told you very clearly that with respect to shielding effect, s orbitals can shield the valency electrons from the nucleus very effectively than p subshell electrons. P subshell electrons can shield the valency electron from the nucleus very effectively than d subshell electrons. D subshell electrons can shield the valency electrons from the nucleus very effectively than f subshell electrons. F subshell electrons cannot shield the valency electrons from the nucleus. So because of that reason, whenever the last electron, ultimate electron, whenever enter into the anti-penultimate shell, that is n minus 2 f subshell, the incoming electron will enter into the anti-penultimate shell in case of f black elements. So because of that reason, nuclear charge increasing, but the shielding effect decreases due to the poor shielding effect of what f electrons. So because of that reason, here in case of actinides, we can identify actinoid contraction. In case of lanthanoids, we can identify lanthanoid contraction. But whereas coming to actinoid contraction and the lanthanoid contraction, actinoid contraction is greater because the shell number is increasing. So whenever the shell number is increases, what happens? The distance between the nucleus and valency electron will increases. So automatically what happens? It cannot shield the valency electrons from nucleus compared with what 4F subshell electrons. So because of that reason, here poor shielding effect of 5F electrons in case of actinoids we can identify compared with what lanthanoids. So this is the reason we have in this question. Next question, you observe that study of actinoid elements is difficult. Why? Because almost all actinoids are radioactive elements. What are the radioactive elements? The elements which can emit the radiation, right? So that's why these radioactive elements we cannot study, right? The actinoids are radioactive elements. That to these actinoid elements we can prepare only in nanogram quantities. So nano means what? 10 to the power of minus 9 gram. Very, very less quantities we can prepare these radioactive elements. So that's why the study of these nanogram quantities of these actinoids is very, very difficult. Okay, na? So these are the important questions we have in case of water D and F black elements. So whatever the questions I have given to you, along with the question, reason, if they ask about reason I have given to you, maximum answer I have given to you, you can practice as it is. Definitely will get 8 of 8 marks from this chapter. No doubt in that, because I have covered all the previous year's questions as well as the questions which they have released from board. Okay, no doubt in that. Compulsory will get 8 marks out of 8 from this chapter. Okay, man. I hope everybody understood. Copy this one and practice properly for the examination. Thank you.